start. Hello everyone and welcome to the video lecture series of mobile application development. Students, in our previous session we have seen that how can we convert the text into the speech by using text-to-speech class. Now, according to the syllabus, we are going to learn about the very basic introduction to working with the camera, where in your syllabus the only thing is that you just need to capture the image and show in your screen. So, once again, welcome everyone. This is your instructor Janice Shah. So now, let me show you some basic examples of camera and the camera class what about. So students, we can capture the pictures without using the instance of camera class. Here, you will use in the intent of the action type which is known as mediastore.action_image_capture to launch the existing camera. So by default event is also there, but for that you just need to write like intent camera intent is equal to new intent android.provider.mediastore.action_image_capture. So this is a very first method where we are not going to use the object of camera and directly can access the camera. Now see, the in Android media store is a type of the database which stores the picture and video in Android. Now the next method is that, and students, the another way to implement the camera is by using the camera class. So camera API works as per the following ways. See, the camera manager is class that is used to get all the cameras available in the devices, like front camera, back camera and every camera. Now the camera device that you can get it from the camera manager by class its ID. Now capture requests, that's you can create the capture request from the camera device to capture the images. Now camera capture session, to get the capture request from the camera device you need to create the capture camera session. Now capture camera session dot capture callback, this is going to be provide the capture session result. So these all are the methods for the camera API, and the permissions for the Android camera you need to write like this, like uses permission Android name android.permission.camera. Okay, now to capture the camera, students, this is my Android manifest file. Okay, and then we need to directly move towards the activity_main.xml file. So see, here I am just taking a relative layout, inside it a text view is there that just normally shows the camera example, and then the button is there which is used to take the capture the photo. Now then when we click the image view, so image view is where is the part where we are going to show the result. Now to capture with the camera, first you need to make object of the image view and the button, and map the XML file with the Java objects, and on click event we just need to call a method which is known as intent camera intent is equal to new intent mediastore.action_image_capture. Now start activity for result, this method is deprecated but still it's working over here. So camera intent comma camera request, we just need to pass both of them, and the next method is on activity result. Students, whenever you try to call a method start activity for results, do not forget to override a method on activity result. So students, when the on activity results, you just need to call as a super dot on activity result request code, result code and data. If the request code is equal to camera request, then this bitmap is photo is created by the data and set the image view this particular photo. So this is how you can work with the camera. Now let me show you the code for the same. So this is my Android manifest file where you just need to write the permissions for the same. Then the activity_main.xml file where I just take a relative layout. Inside the relative layout, my height and width is a match parent. Text view is there. This is the camera example. If I want to make it little bit good, then you can also says as a size. So text size is a 20 dp and center horizontal true. So now it looks good. If you want to give the margin, then also you can give the margin. Margin is a 20 dp each. Okay, so layout margin is 20 dp. Wait a minute, Okay, now it looks good. Fine. So this is the text view, students. Now on the below of that I have taken a button. This is my button, okay, which is on the below of the particular, I can say, the text view. Let me just make it as a layout below ID. What is the ID of the particular text view? Let me just check it out. It's a title TV. So let me give it title TV. Okay, now so it's done. So it's everything is successfully done. Now let me just give the margin to a particular one is a 20 dp. Fine. So now it looks good. This is my button. Button ID is camera button. Image view is there where I take a 300 dp image view and set the default image as a drawable IC launcher foreground. Fine. Now let me just get back to the main activity.java file where on create method is there, camera button, image view is there, mapped with the XML objects, and on camera button set on click listener. This is my intent, camera intent, new intent, media store.action, image capture, and camera intent, camera request. I just take the camera request by using start activity for result method. Whenever I try to write the start activity for result, which is deprecated method, but still it's working in Android, you need to override the on activity result method, which contains the three different parameters, result code, result request code, and intent data. Now see, this is the intent data. Now bitmap photo is equal to get extra dot get. This is the data, so you can write anything inside the data instead of data. Okay, so image view dot set image bitmap and the photo. Photo is a variable, fine, which we have created. So now let me just show the whole code. See, okay, so what we need to do over here, bitmap object will pass inside the set image bitmap and we can set the image inside our view. So now just let me run the code and show the output first. See, so whenever I'm trying to click the photo, okay, see, this is a take photo. So application is opening. Now let me just click the photo. Okay, it's done. Now click on the okay. See, so you can able to see the image that we have clicked in your phone, right? So this is the camera example, students. So students, this is all about the working with camera in Android. This program is only suitable as per your syllabus only. If you want to learn more in the camera, I'll try to make the more videos, but it's not in your syllabus. So if you're in doubt, then please feel free to ask me. Thank you so much.